Okay. Hopefully my internet isn't total ass. So apologies if it is. Not much I can do about it regardless. Nope, that input delay is not gonna work. No, no, no. That felt like a solid half a second. Nope, that still feels pretty bad. Yeah, that feels better. Yep, my Wi-Fi is being ass. Who'd have thought? Well, not much I can do about it. Apologies. It is what it is. Thank you. happens to boys? This is the wrong fairy island. Grab some money while I'm here. Kazunari was not hinted one way or the other. Careful, I'm gonna be doing a super swim, so if you're sensitive to flashing lights, you might want to look away. Thank you. full clenching right there. Holy shit. I think I was frames away from drowning. If you want to watch somebody who's good at super swims, don't watch me. Let me tell you that much. Because I only learned it, like, this season too, so... Oh yeah, and look at the dropped frames. 30% drop frames. I'll upload this to YouTube, I'm sorry. Check if we got a bottle or anything before we go. No, we did not. We got a boomerang. What would you windfall into crescent maybe? Oops, I don't want that. Time. Milo's still moving, sadly. Maybe we do. I do got time. That's fine. Again, scuffed, but once Milo starts moving, you're not on the clock, or you don't have to worry about too much. As long as you just don't get seen. That's a 1% chance, I think. That red rupee. Doesn't hurt to check. Alright, well, here's all the free money you need for the seed. Sometimes that happens. Bonk. I don't need to grab Tot here because I got a Picto, but normally you would grab Tot if you didn't get a Picto. I'll be doing Lensu door cancel. Thank you. definitely wait to grab Tot until you're doing hide and seek. Second pick though. That's vanilla too, I think. I do a trick called Door Cancel, which lets me get a really tiny hitbox. And this is helpful for hide and seek, as well as breaking into the upper chest at Lenz's house. Much easier than riding the entire windmill, because the windmill's a little slow to ride. It's also helpful with hide and seek, because I can go through walls and save quite a bit of time there. Hide and seek is one of those checks you kind of get a feel for where they're going to run if you do it so many times. Like here, I'm rolling towards the next kid already as I catch that other one. Very kind start to the seed, if I'm being honest. Makes me a little suspicious. You can't catch this last kid with door cancel, so you have to catch him afterwards. Well, you can't knock down this him from the tree, specifically, with door cancel hitboxes, as far as I'm aware. This kid, I like to just let him fake himself out by just running towards where I know he's gonna go. Kind start to the seed. The deluxe picture box, you can use the same picture for two different checks, so it's kind of nice little time save there. We got the Faroi's Pearl now. Grab here. Oops. Crescent Moon or something, so there's no need to peek at the telescope from far away, but normally you should peek this from as far as you can in the quadrant with the telescope. That way you don't have to sail as far if it's nothing, and more likely than not, it's always nothing. Or more likely than not, it's going to be nothing, statistically, just based on number of items versus number of checks. But since it was hinted, we know it is something. Careful not to speak to the King Red Lions, because every time you do so, you'll lose quite a bit of time with these hints. We're about to get Salvage Core at Western Ferry after doing the swim. Normally you should do that. We already checked Beetle, we know it's nothing, so don't worry about that. But you could grab Beetle there. If you saw something earlier. Wow, very generous seed. Fourth heart already. To worry about scale of the wall, which is why I came here early. Typically, you want to try and greet Pop Ramp by putting it off as long as you can until you can get every single check, but you can peak it if we didn't have these items, which unfortunately this is a bad example seed, so you don't get to see the way you peak it. But you can sidle along a wall. Nothing. Alright. You can sidle along a wall and then climb up that boulder on the left, the first check I went towards, and you'll sort of flip out of balance by yourself. It's not too bad. It can be a little finicky to find the right spot. Again, I'll upload this to YouTube. The volume is garbage. Wi-Fi is being garbage. Mm-hmm. bad movement there. Fairies are good because they give you some time to think about what your next move is going to be. I'm thinking I'm going to go to Outset, Horseshoe Island, I could do Leafless Golf, then go to Diamond Step, which is in Logic. And depending on what I get, maybe Peak Needle Rock Chest? Unsure. Definitely, okay. Frames are we dropping? 32%. Yep, that sounds about right. I guess there's no point in worrying about it further. It is what it is. I swear that's always a tingle statue. This is a good luck, Golden Devil. Sorry about the frame drops. Not much I can do about it. It's pretty friggin' choppy. Oops. Hope you're doing well. This roll clip can be especially tricky if you're you have to worry about angle and timing. So I like to make it so that I can just have to worry about holding straight up, so I don't have to worry about the camera or the angle that I jump at. When I do the trick, so I only have to worry about timing. Comes generally a lot easier. Here's another island you can get salvage core at, although usually probably not one I would recommend. You only really want to come here if you're going to do this with golf. This golf, I'm just gonna kill this other guy because it's usually annoying beyond belief. Okay. Messes up the L targeting. That's not gonna work. Hey Tanjo, thanks for the good luck. Sorry about the frame drops. Again, nothing I can do. Internet's trash, as usual. Tournament. Ah, how was that seed? Hopefully it went well. Fucked your ass, huh? There we go. True. Very good point. Looks like we do have something in golf. Leafless golf is one of those tricks. Just, ugh. Can be very difficult and very finicky. Definitely a lot of time saves elsewhere to worry about first. Alright. Well, if we get another bow and then magic, both in diamond step, I guess we can do the other place. Needle rock. Oh yeah, I'm doing this seed as sort of a async, kind of. It's a race, but somebody else ran the seed earlier and they asked us to review it, or not review it, to race it so they can see what we did, so they can improve. So I think I'm racing a few others on this seed right now. So, yeah. Kind of just trying to add some maybe useful tips. And I'm definitely going to have to upload this to YouTube because my bitrate's probably trash and I'm dropping a lot of frames. So I learned if you don't hold up on that last roll and you just let it fall to neutral, you don't ever bonk against that thing. Which is actually pretty nice. I have hammer, I probably should have used it, but I'm just gonna use the stick. Whoops. Alright, well now you get to see me use hammer. Alright, well, of the options I've got left, I don't really like any of them too much, to be honest. I don't really like any of them. So I'm gonna go to Angular Peak. Whoops. Angular Peak is Sphere Zero, and it has stuff more often than I would like. Like, way more often. The trick is that you need Mirror Shield to get whatever's in the cave. But if you're lucky, and thanks to CTMC, you can tell what's inside, and sometimes it'll be dead. Like right there, I saw they didn't have spikes at the top, so I don't need to get Angular Cave. Use some of my precise hookshot to get up to this chest from where you spawn after you save the warp. the input I mean. The Tingle Statues, it wasn't very helpful. Let's go do Windfall stuff. Into Cyclos, probably. Really? Didn't even give it a shot? That was scuffed. Thank fuck nobody saw that. Yeah, I'm sorry. It's definitely just unwashable. I apologize. I'll have to upload this to YouTube. Alright, well, the only thing we got was a bottle, which doesn't really push me anywhere. So I'm gonna go to Dragon Roost. Get the outside checks first, I think. And enter the ERC. Usually I'd like to have bombs slash fire and ice arrows for DRC slash leaf plus magic. In addition to a grappling hook, you know, the item that's used to beat the dungeon, but I'm running out of spices to check. He already knows his hinted command melody. That's why I didn't bother to peek it. Did the same exact thing last time. I'm gonna stop L-targeting that. This is hinted. Command melody. Song of Passing, see what I got. Song of Passing reloads the area after you store a chest. 8 bag. But you don't roll up the stairs. Thought it was safe. Well, I'm out of here for now. Not much else I can do in here. Got myself a fairy. I haven't decided from where yet.
Thank you.
Cathedral Shop is always so awkward to menu correctly and efficiently. One of my personal weaknesses. Target Grandma from pretty far away. Anywhere on the carpet generally works. It should be. Big Pig can do 3 hearts of damage, so be very careful when you do this strategy. Because you can get one shot. It doesn't lose a lot of time, but it loses a fair bit. Pearl of some set a kind, I think. Yeah. Pearler bombs. I have to keep an eye on the clock here because I've got the ghost ship in a decent spot. Not a great spot, a decent spot. But it gets to a much worse spot if I miss it tonight. Time you see the clock in this view, it means time is passing. If the clock's in another view, then time is not passing. So, at headstone, time is not passing. At outset, head is not. Time is not passing. Close to those islands. So, in between the two, it was. So, it's usually generally close to like any significant island, time will not pass. Which isn't helpful all the time, but that's good to know. Nothing. We're gonna go ship here at Spectacle Island, which again isn't a great spot, but it's better than the next spot it would rotate to, which would be Five Star Isles, which is in the very bottom right corner of the map, like the most bottom right most quadrant. And that's a long sail to get there too. It's not a fast sail. This is a somewhat long sail, but it could be a lot worse. We're gonna use the telescope to peek the chest, see it's nothing, and just save warp right out. No need to fight it at all. Oh yeah, need to mark off Cabana Key. I'm down to do some shenanigans here on Taji, first floor. Can't get everything, we can get a few checks. Out of logic. Well, we can technically get every check on this floor out of logic, but it's kind of a pain. And this is typically not a play you will see done. Almost ever. Oh. I bypassed the bomb requirement with this, so. Again, this play is very rarely seen. Because it's not commonly needed at all. I just happened to do this because I wanted to do check density along the way to Cabana. Once I will get hop across. Because I'm already here. Might as well. For this trick, you want to hold... Counterintuitively, you want to hold full left. And the amount of time you hold full left will determine whether you grab onto the ledge or drop off. The longer you hold in general, the more likely you are to stick onto the ledge and keep holding it, which is generally what you want to do for setups. But for there, you want to fall onto the ground so that way you can... Thank you. No reason to watch the rest of the animation and save warp. Just hit soft reset. F11 on Dolphin is the default, I believe. At least for computers. And X plus B plus up, I believe, up on the D-pad. If you hold those at the same time, you get a soft reset as well, which is what I typically do after saving. Because if you do it after you hit the save button, then it'll automatically soft reset on the first available possible frame that you can. Same with the if you're doing it on a console as well. Make sure you're not facing directly towards the post box when you're playing songs and passing, because otherwise you will feed your Wind Waker to the mailbox and it loses quite a bit of time. I'm not liking the seed so far. It's a nice, deceptively kind start, but you'd be efficient with your routing in the top right quadrant. And then it's kind of been a mean linear treasure hunt afterwards. I've seen worse. This one's still pretty rough. I'm already going to be double dipping two different dungeons, which is typically not what you want to do. You want to put off dungeons as long as you can until you can do them efficiently. Fucking bitch. That's my name for this rat. This one's absolute cunt. Those are absolute cunts. Fucking bitches. Self-explanatory, honestly. All these plays really suck. Like, really, really suck. DRC is probably the best of the plays. where do I enter DRC? That's kind of the rub there. That's wooden? Yeah, it is. I just have to go through vanilla or do the full one skip and Taji, but like, no. I mean, I did it just fine the first time, it's just... I don't want to go back into Taji until I've got bombs, preferably Leaf as well. No, Leaf can't be locked behind Command Melody, which is pretty great, honestly. We know it's not deep in Taji. So nothing in deep Taji helps get us our Leaf or magic. Although we did get Grappling Hook, so maybe that's wrong. Maybe that's a lie. I think that might be wrong. Because I have a grappling hook, I can do this. I could grab this chick before I grappling hook, but I can now go back to the entirety of the dungeon with storage. I really hate these bridges in DRC, so I'm gonna be honest, I tend to not like to go super fast over top of them because they tend to be very inconsistent. If you hold straight up, sometimes you'll go up correctly, sometimes you'll just go slightly to the side, and that could cause you to roll off the edge, so yeah. Magic. I don't have anything that uses magic at the moment. I'm gonna do this strat again. It's nothing, I just grapple. I ignore them. Miniboss was hinted dead. Why did I do that? Alright, well the right chest is the big key. hardest time finding this guy. Why? Like, see here? I'm holding straight up and I'm drifting to the side. Also dropping roller coasters. That's a separate issue. Need at least one key to go through these doors backwards, so. An item in the big key chest. We need to go grab that. Ooh. Spiky. Ugh, bait. I don't need that. If you see a chest like that over here, it's always going to be a big key because it's locked behind you with four other keys, so you know that. want to be behind him for this final one. That way you land right in front of the eye and can start damaging as soon as this phase is over. Small little optimization. Yep, trash. As in, the Wi-Fi is trash, so... checked again. Options are really, really bad. ET is out of loading, thank God. We've got Zunari and we've got On Tree Branch. As logically leading to Leaf.
God, those robots aren't. Ugh.
Who knows? Should have equipped Hookshot. So I want to Hookshot over to this mailbox here. Not worth the time now to get with it. Well, then this has to be something that leads to Leaf. Ooh, Wind Waker dive here to get into Forest Haven a fair bit faster. Like, a lot faster than doing it the vanilla way. It's Vanilla Leaf! Wow. That's messed up. That's really messed up. Especially with Grappling Hook being where it was. We saw this with Spikey early, so I'm going to prioritize it now. You should do it. Good luck, Kiwi. Yeah, I'm sorry. My stream has been buffering really badly, so I'm gonna have to upload this to YouTube after I'm done. So, I've had so many disconnects and frame drops. My Wi-Fi is being bad. But yeah, I hope you find these helpful. Improving. Which gives me an excuse to race as well. Always welcome. Yeah, I'll let you know whenever I've got it uploaded to YouTube. Because I guarantee you, it's just unwatchable on Twitch at the moment. I'm seeing like 80% frame drops. This, we'll check mail, then head into Earth Temple. What's the current frame drops at? Oh! 54% frame drops! Only half as bad as it should be. Yo, Tanjo, thanks for counting each lost frame. You're gonna be counting for a while, though. Yeah, I'll let you know. DM you. Also, Tanja, while you're here, when is A6? Speaking of my file name. Shit. Oh, into Earth Temple or do this one off check? Too far. I'm not going into Earth Temple, I'll tell you that. I'm gonna do the one-off check. Lifetime? Probably the number of CS you missed. Did A6 already happen? Oh. Well, A7. No, don't grab that. You fucker. Thank you. This ledge grab barely saves any time, but I've started going for it again. Because it does save time. Slightly. If you get a first try, if you jump off like I did, it doesn't save time. It loses quite a bit. I feel like we started at A6 at the start of the Season 5 tournament, so we gotta start A7 soon, right? When Season 7 Moonmaker happens? Ah. So we're taking the season off, let me see. Understandable. Oops. Hit an F11 when I was on the tracker. It's still in beta. Ah, I see. Maybe I should just not hit F11 and just hold the actual soft reset combo. Alright. Earth Temple, Sphere 7, 5 checks available, no bombs. Very little other items. Boy, I sure hope we don't have to double dip every single dungeon this seed. YouTuber you turned into but never followed. Sure. The Tanjo 3 VTuber? Yeah? Oh, as in follow them. Do it. Alright, keys. It doesn't help me, so I'm not gonna grab it. Get the skull, please. Thank you. I'll just walk. Ooh, that was close. Now it looks wooden. No bombs! Right. Alright, well, here's the logical third key we need to get to the basement. Oh. Oh, it's only second key, so there's one of them in the floor master's room. Then. We do left side here. Probably not, no. Next slide, I'm sorry. All right, well, there's bombs. Finally. Oh, all right. So we're actually logically keylocked here. Angular did not have magic, no. There we go. Magic was in fly across, or under rope bridge, sorry. Expecting really nice. Just to be sure, that's close enough. I say I don't need the magic. Too bad. Not fast though. Alright, all this stuff's logically locked behind fire and ice. I don't see why we don't just... Whoa, where is the shard? I didn't store a key, so I don't have to worry about that. This is a real pain to get back to, let me tell you that. Thank you. Why does their hitbox only extend to the top of their head if you're above them? I don't have a key, so I need to void out. Small key. Yeah. Here's the other key. Don't need it. Doesn't matter what this is, I need to grab the chest to get back out. Alphas can just be mean to you sometimes, and it's just pure RNG, so... Okay, well that's the big key. Oh, come on, get the chip pot, please. So left side takes an L. Thank you. my boomerang on the wrong buttons. That's why I fucked that up. Alrighty, basement gang also taking an L. Survey says, go fuck yourself. That's what the survey is telling me. The rest of Earth Temple is entirely barren. Alright, well, I'm going to continue to skip the rest of the overworld. Cool. You fucked rat. The closer those side hops are to frame perfect, the better. Less likely you are to get hit. So I had a fair chance of getting hit from one of those because they weren't perfect. I have no idea if that jump slash is faster. I just do it out of habit at this point. I've bonked on those stairs more often than I would have liked as of late, so I've stopped rolling up them. To adjust my normal way I do this if I want to do this like top side of this room like I saw I had to do earlier. I thought G was the place to be. Again, I use the middle of the statue oscillations as the guideline for when I'm good to jump. Like if I'm crossing between light and dark, then I'm good to go. About halfway through each. Just use the thing to cross the first time. It might have been faster, less risky too. Less risk of me missing this cycle. I think it would have been better. Boss was hinted dead, which is why I skipped it. Got enough shard on Windfall yet? We have not. This is the big key. We'll skip it.
Yeah.
I don't remember if it was faster to get the big key or not if it's top of floating platforms. I remember there was a discussion about this a long time ago. Between Slam and Spytron, I think? The only reason I remember it is because I think it got heated. What's up, Koala? GG's. This seat is pretty trash. Thanks for the raid. Hopefully my frames aren't being trash again. Take care of Doggo. Alright, go pet the Doggo. Take care of him. Thanks for the good luck. We're down to 24% frames dropped. That's not bad. We're getting better. I want to try this strat I saw. I think it was... It might have been Blank's Eye I saw do this the other day. Curious how well this works. Oh. Oh yeah, that's way better than doing the RNG jump. Hell yeah. Alright, well, I've got a new strat. I swear this chest is weird. There we go. The drop was weird on that. Jump slashing stairs to portal. No, I've got an Ethernet cord. My Wi-Fi just sucks. Massive. Something. I actually use a 100-foot Ethernet cord. My Wi-Fi on my phone isn't much better. Not wireless, so. That's cool. Instant hand respawn. Thank you. I have Cox Communications. So, they're my ISP. Not by choice, believe you me. So we pay for the best internet plan they've got. And it looks trash. Alright, we've got a shard hinted on Windfall. So it's gonna be... It's not the transparent chest, because I saw that. So it's gotta be Creeb. Creeb's got a shard. Where else do we go? Probably go Southern Fairy and Ice Ring. Look for the bow. And the other two shards. Southern Fairy and Ice Ring gets us 5 total checks. So we do that first, even. Because we can't get all of our checks at Creeb. And maybe we pass enough time a day. Also, yeah, I love how I said, hey, stream's doing better. 24% frames drop, only 24%, and then instantly, stream disconnects. Very cool. Yep, regional monopoly. Well, that wasn't the direction I wanted to fly. In theory, I guess I should have checked mail first. There's 2 checks of mail. They could have both been my required items, but then this Southern Fairy would have been a waste of time. Eh. It is what it is. Also, this seat is not sub-2-ing. Right, I deleted the other letter. Not deleted. I soft reset. Alright, well now I'm not punished. Perfect. This was already nothing. We checked this earlier. I soft reset it. Here it's better to not equip your fire and ice arrows, even though it's tempting as you get in the boat. Wait until you get there, because then you can equip all 3 at once. Your brain goes, oh, ice ring, I need to equip my fire and ice arrows because I need them there. But you need more than 3 things to do it as fast as possible. You need more than just 1 item. Nice. Skip Fire Mountain. And the other check. And Needle Rock Interior. We full cleared an empty Earth Temple besides his bombs, which kind of sucks. So again, we had a shard hinted on Windfall, but I do not have any Windfall shards. So it has to be here. signal should already be on. To see where this will land me. So I figured. Alright, Creeb, giving you my shard, as the legends foretold. Thank you. Well, I didn't have the best execution, and the routing was pretty unfortunate to see, so. The seed was mean, though, so. I'll say my storages were pretty decent, except for that big key chest storage in Taji. I think the rest of them were actually really good. Some minor movement stuff in the routing. I fully expect to lose to Rick for this one. Nice, taking care of the doggo. Close out strong. That's what I'm known for, my good execution, especially in the end game. Right. That's why you watch me. I've got 4 arrows. Where do I pick up more arrows? Pick up some arrows on the stairs. I have enough magic to make the gap. Yeah, there's Rick finishing. That's what I figured. Definitely a lot of room for improvement. But mostly the routing was shit. Because the seat is trash. Had to double dip DRC and go the long way. Double dip. Taught G because I did most of it out of logic. Without bombs. Did I double dip Earth Temple? No, I didn't, but I full cleared that. Put out my sword there. Yeah, I had to go to a bunch of... I went to Great Fish, I feel like... 3 times? Question mark? I'm surprised it didn't work. Alright, 3 arrows, I can get the first 3. And by that time, the cycles don't matter. I Really? You're gonna deflect it? Alright, buddy. Deflect the arrow. Big jerk. Strong in-game execution, right here. Well, three of my last four PG1s have been bat cycles, which sucks. So, these are pretty bad. I guess I'll need to practice that. Thanks to the raid, Hia the Hero. I'll come on in. Just finishing up a seat. Pretty bad Wind Waker seat in terms of difficulty. Item input location. Frickin' vanilla leaf with magic and underground bridge. That'd be gross. Alright, well, we got the doubles on that. So. PG2s have been good. I'll say that. PG1s, not so much. Need to save my magic. Chalk shot, true. Not consistent in game, Snatch. Alright, just drink the soup now. Oh, yeah, good rip climb. I started vibrating the controller now instead of doing the thumb mashing method, and I'm getting better at it. Instead of the method where you just jitter your finger as fast as you can. It's better on your wrists. Better on your entire hand, honestly. That was weird. Alright, well, I can't say I've seen that before. He just hopped away. Yeah. He just did it again there. That's weird. Point blank, right in the ribs. Thanks for the GGs. And yeah, I'll upload this to YouTube overnight, because... You're not going to be able to watch much of the VOD due to frame drops. Let's see. I also don't have primes. I don't have any subs, because I'm not Twitch Fire, so don't worry about it. Funnily enough. Alright, well, I'm gonna stop streaming and go get some dinner. Maybe play some League in a bit. But for now, GG's. Thanks for watching. Yeah, I'll upload this to YouTube. But have a great rest of the day. See ya.